is Wing Chun Matrix time. So as I have mentioned in my previous video that I'll make one more Wing Chun videos when my books Wing Chun Matrix is releasing or released. So Wing Chun Matrix, the books will be released or in the process of releasing within 2 weeks, okay? And so today, I'm going to share with you my last video. And so this video is like in the Silicon Valley. Sometimes we work in corporations and we finish the project and then we leave the company. And after we no longer with the company, we go for the exit interview, okay? And then we just present everything what we do for the company, and then we leave, and that's it, okay? So today I'm going to share with you what I share better in video than in the book Wing Chun Matrix, okay? And also I'm going to share with you a big picture of my work, okay? By definitions, today I have already retired, or meaning I have left the company, because in February 1st, 2018, I already announced it worldwide that I retire from Wing Chun. So today is, by definitions, I already no longer within Wing Chun, and today I want to speak as a scientist, a researcher. Okay? So that's how I want to proceed with this video. Okay? So you can use this video later to help you to understand the book better, okay? Wise vessel. Now, so today I want to use this board, like usually when people have this exit interview, we have all kinds of lists that we have to be responsible to tell everybody where things are. Okay, so, Wing Chun Matrix, or my work, up to now, or the Wing Chun West education platform, it is focused on technology, okay? It is about science and technology. It is not about to correct others or to make I know the most older, most authentic Wing Chun, those kind of stuff, okay? What in my channel up to now presenting is about the science and technology on Wing Chun based on ancient data or evidence. It's not my own opinion, okay? It's based on ancient data mapped into science, namely the physics, biomechanics. So the bottom line of my job, or what I'm working on, is to find a solution, to provide a solution. And so do not take my word as to point finger at somebody saying that this is not authentic, that's not authentic, this is Wing Chun, that's not Wing Chun, okay? My presentation, my work, is about to find out what it is and the solutions. It is not about those stuff, okay? And I repeat this because there's many, many times when I present a technical case before even people finish listening to what I'm talking, right away jump into, you don't know Wing Chun. Wing Chun is this, Wing Chun is that. And then it gets into this lineages and all kinds of politics. So for you guys who watch this video, I want to make it clear today. Those are not my goal. Whenever I present, if you notice in my video and so forth, I present technical. If I say something is wrong, I tell you why it is. It is just like your gear in the car transmissions. If you pull to the back gear instead of forward when you want to drive the car, that's called wrong. Got nothing to do with my opinion or anything. And got nothing to do with anybody's lineage or any grandmaster. Okay? So let us get this clear here. It is about science. And because it is about science, also don't get into those the fight between the science and religions. We in technology and science do not have 350 years like the case of the world is not spinning, world is spinning around the sun, where only after 350 years the church acknowledged that. Okay, so we are not getting to that. We just solidly like in Silicon Valley. This is the evidence, this is the solution. That's all. That's what I'm doing. Okay? Got nothing to do with anybody's politics or anybody's lineage or anything. That's what I always say. It got nothing to do with that. And I don't have lineage. I present what is the finding or by evidence. Okay? This is very important because we don't want to misfocus. We want to solve technical issue, understand technical issue, and evolve. Okay, that is how science progress. So, if later on somebody decide to use this Wing Chun West platform as the base of their Wing Chun practice, and then so name it as American Wing Chun, because whatever I present here is actually work and experiment and conclude in Silicon Valley, America. You can call it American Wing Chun. That is not politics. That is just a label so that people can differentiate what type of platform is that particular person's Wing Chun. Okay? And it is perfectly fine for those who practice today's general Wing Chun to practice what they want, because this is a freedom, okay? It's like freedom of speech, freedom of religion. And here again, I really stress on, it is technology I'm presenting here, which is mapping the ancient Wing Chun teaching into today's scientific, which is I am focusing on in my work is about. Okay, now see, if we look into the ancient scriptures, okay, we can see that the ancient actually up to now is in martial art, quote unquote, the art. In Chinese, it should say technology, because it's wushu. Su is technology, it's not art. Okay. We can see it is actually a technology which is evolving since 500 years ago, then the Qi Ji Guang. It is not living in a time capsule or box oneself inside a box. You can read on General Qi Ji Guang writing. You can read on the Shaolin short strike writing. They are evolving. They are not living in the box. They get out the box. And even though they don't use the scientific physics term today, they are doing that. Okay? So, what I'm doing is to present what has been there, the practice of the Chinese, like General Qi Ji Guang, the Shaolin short strike, and even the 1850s Xiu Lin Tao, which is a merge, a fusion of the Shaolin short strike to Ermei Shi Er Zhuang, and then to the Sam White Crane. This is all is not living in the box. It is it is actually expanding, and then it is not living in a time capsule. Okay. And today we can see, for example, if you look at the Japanese jujitsu, they have done a very good job in evolving in a scientific way. For example, if you look at say jujitsu 1600, go look at the history of jujitsu 1600. Okay. At the time, it involved with this Chinese name Chen Yanbing, Qin Ganbing, something. Okay, you search in the jujitsu. This involved in the evolutions, and then you get to Kano, 1880. Well, Kano, the father of judo, is actually a college graduate, right? Studied university, and then later on you get into what? You get into math, into physics, judo, you get into Olympics. And then if you look at Gracio family, BJJ, Brazilian Jiu Jitsu, they did a good job. If I'm not wrong, the year is around 1930s or something. And then it evolved over generations, and today it has so much development, which is scientific, okay? Because these all are science-based. You know, after Kano, you see things as science-based, okay? So you can see that it is not living in a box. All these excellent people, like today's Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, it is good. Why? Scientific base. It is evolved for hundreds of years, many generations of people. Okay? And that we have to respect, because people do their job. You look at the like Georgian Jiu-Jitsu people, they can handle different parts of their body and so forth. They can have details into it. That's what we need to respect people. We need to learn from those. That is technology. They develop their technology, they evolve it. Okay? And being not living within a box, one can learn everything. Okay? Now, in the Wing Chun, we look at it. Okay? Say, 1560, General Qi Ji Guang, he evolved it. Okay? You get the concept like today's MMA. In the writing of the Shaolin Sword Strike, 1784, you can see that even the preface, it say that it was evolved and people fusion different art to make the to evolve it to be bad. When you look at the Yikang Shuling Hao Kut, 1850, you know that the Erme is fusion into that. The base is the Shaolin Sword Strike. Okay? And then you look into the 1960s, Grandmaster Ip Man's and students going scientific way. On the other way, like my late teacher, Grandmaster Cho Hong Choi, in Penang, Malaysia, he also is a scientific guy who evolved into a scientific way. Otherwise, I will not be like that, okay? Now, so Wing Chun is also in the path of traveling into the evolving with scientific. And what my job, which I conclude now, I leave the company now after this project done, is just following what the trend of the world. No big deal. Okay? So this is very important. Now, a few things I like to share with you today so that you are clear where is this thing come from when I'm presenting. Okay? It's very clear. First thing, When I say this is not yi ji kam yang ma, this is yi ji kam yang. This is yang, yin side, yin or yang. There is evidence for that. The first evidence is if you read the Ermei Shi Er Zhuang writing, it tells you this is the yang side, and it tells you that how that the court, the Yit Kam Shu Lin Tao creed of the Yi Ji Kam Yang Ma 1850s. The second thing I want to show you today, okay, is from the Shaolin Short Strike Canon. This is called Bi Yin Da Fa. Bi Yin meaning you seal off your yin. And this leg is actually the toe slightly in. The toe slightly in. That is called sealing the yin. Okay? So, from both Shaolin Short Strike and the Ermei Shi Er Zhuang, we know clearly this is yin. This is called sealing of the yin or clamping the yin. This is the yang. This is clamping yang. While this is clamping yin. Okay? So it is not just one data point, one count. You can see in the Shaolin Short Strike Canon and the Ermei Shi Er Zhuang both saying the same thing. Okay? That's why I'm so sure what I'm talking about. And actually, it is not about my opinion, but it is speak based on evidence. So now you know where it is from. Okay? Whoever wants to argue a difference, that is no longer my issue. And that is actually not my issue. They can go argue with the ancestor, the Chinese short strike ancestor who wrote that that Shaolin Short Strike Canon, or the Ermei Shi Er Zhuang ancestor who wrote that Ermei Shi Er Zhuang Canon. Alright, okay. I'm just a messenger. Show you the thing. The second thing. The other day I was showing the guardian stance. So where is this guardian stance from instead of this thing? Okay, this is usually people see in a movie this way or this way or this way. I'm using this. So where is this from? Okay, front view, side view. Okay, well, the same. This is Shaolin Canon. This is what it is. It's described very clearly there. Okay? So, what I'm talking about is not my opinion again. I am actually just a messenger. Presenting what is there in writing, Shaolin Short Strike Canon. Okay. Now, as for the short strike, I'm presenting same thing within the Shaolin Short Strike Canon. And it is all writing there. Okay, to show what it is. It's defined there. And also the other day, I was presenting the so-called dodging the shadow And then Tong Na. So in the, if this is the lead arm, lead leg, lead arm, if I go here, it is called dodging the shadow, Do Ying. If I enter from here, this is called Tong Na, or this is called Shawling Move. Well,
it is here recorded. Okay, so this is clearly said here, Teng Ma. Okay, those of you who know Chinese is there. Okay, Teng Na. Okay, it's here. So it said, Teng Na Pian San Shi. You dodging, Tong Na way of dodging side.
So, I mean this clear here, here on you know, okay, what it is, where to look for. And again, I have already left, by definition already retired. So you guys can look at things, and anybody want to argue, go argue with the Shaolin Short Strike canon composer Xianji, Meng Xianji, and his student, Meng Xianji from Shaolin, and his student, or Meister Erzhuang. It is not Hendrik's issue. Okay? So I never put down anybody's lineages or grandmaster. I present what is the facts by writing of the ancient. Okay? So want to make that clear, I'm just a scientist. A researcher, I present what it is. Okay? Now, the next thing is, I want to present you two lists within the Wing Chun Matrix books. Within that, there's many, many things there, but I'm going to present two of you in here so that you can understand, because it's better to explain with the vision or video action here, so you know what it is. By writing, you guessing. I don't want that. Okay, I want exactly. If today one person watch this movie, this video, even though my English is my fourth language, I don't know much about English or bad English. You know what exactly it is. Okay, and that is different. Difficult to be written within the books. Okay, so you can use this with the books, or you don't have to buy the books. Okay, if you know what I'm talking about, and or you have enough data and so forth. So now I'm going to show you the list. Okay, and I want you to freeze the screen so that you see what it is when I'm presenting. Okay, I just try to get a good thing for you so you can freeze the screen and then you see what I'm talking. Okay, this is a very bad here because of the shadow. Maybe I can tweak a little bit here if it's make it better. Yeah. Okay, you can snapshot the screen. And another one, this is the content Wing Chun. Another one is the Wing Chun technical analysis. Okay. Now you always can turn into that and look into it. Okay. Now, let's get into the contents of Wing Chun Qin. The content of the Wing Chun Qin. The first in the list of the contents of Wing Chun Qin is that specialize in the short strike and takedown momentum zone. Okay, so I want to define for you here to clearly tell you what does it mean. So we know per general Qi Ji Guang, made into today's language, fighting is an exchange of impulse momentum within the four momentum zone, namely the long fist zone, which is going to do strike and kick, those kind of stuff, long fist zone, short strike zone, this close, takedown zone, even closer, and then ground fighting zone. Okay, so you have four zones in fighting, but we classify, we coin it today, what the general Qi Ji Guang presented. Okay, and then you can look into the Chinese martial art, they all have this kind of thing in this war zone. Now, Wing Chun specialized in this zone, the short strike zone and the takedown zone. Okay, so Wing Chun characteristic is to get in here to KO the other guy in multiple, like machine gun, and it can attack with all the balls, meaning that from the sweep, from the elbow, from the hip, this sweep, the knee, hip, elbow, shoulder, fist. That is how Wing Chun will attack or strike or KO the opponent. That is the way they specialize of Wing Chun. And then of course the throw, okay? So Wing Chun is specialized in the short strike zone and the takedown zone. You guys can go watch my other Wing Chun Matrix video, which is have more illustration on this, okay? Now, so we need to know that even though Wing Chun aware of this four zone, Wing Chun is specialized on the short strike zone and the takedown zone. Why you need to aware of all zone? Because you cannot box yourself into a box. You have to handle different scenario from different zone, but it's specialized in this zone. Okay? Now, so that's the first in the list. If you want to talk about the content of Wing Chun, that's what it is. The second is impulse momentum handling and biomechanics development in terms of the H3C, the Trinity, and the force flow for its special lipid. So in other words is, in order to specialize in this short strike zone and takedown zone, one need to develop the impulse momentum handling and the biomechanics, and it has to develop the H3C, which is meaning the body has to be flexible, be able to do the job, the seven bowls, well handled. The handle of the center of gravity in dynamic. And then the handle of the four handles, which is the handling of the how to handle impulse momentum or how to generate impulse momentum. There are four handles there. Okay. And then finally the force flow. Okay. So in order to specialize the Wing Chun, which is specialized in the short strike zone and the takedown zone, one need to specialize the H3C, the Trinity, the force flow for this type of art, which is named Wing Chun. One thing I can tell you is that notice of the term force flow. That is one of the uniqueness of Wing Chun. Okay, which is I'm going to show you the details with example illustration here, so you can see what is impulse momentum handling, what is biomechanic with this H3C, Trinity, and the force flow. Okay. Now, the first thing I'll impose momentum. Say if I do a punch this way. Okay, a punch this way. It was perfectly fine punch, right? I rotate my hip, I punch up like usual, I punch this way, right? Now, that's one way of handling impulse momentum or general impulse momentum. Now, with the same punch, this is a long fist punch, long fist middle punch, okay? If I do this, so versus a standing still here, I rotate, I punch this way, or you see the difference in the impulse generations. And you know that this one is the entire body, which is I call the trinity, the body, the leg, and the arm, one piece. While, okay, this is one piece, body, leg, and arm, one piece. While on this, you see that the trinity, which is the body, the feet, and the arm, is different than the first one, than this one, okay? So if you use impulse momentum theorem, impulse is your mass multiplied by the change of the velocity. Thus, with this, you can see that this have more impulse generate because there's an entire body's goal than a stood here there and turning. That is the handles of the impulse momentum. That's why you need the impulse momentum theorem to understand in detail what is going on, what is the difference between this and this. Okay, this is a long range, long phase range impulse momentum. Now, short strike. Short strike art also using the trinity. The body, the feet, the body, the leg, and then the arm. But it is not a long fist art. So the short strike art is more like the American football tackle. Okay? You see? It's not. But okay, this is short strike up mechanics, short strike up impulse momentum. And for this tackling, that is named as thrust. In the Wing Chun, say, let's all take tone. You disengage and you thrust. So that is what it is. Different mechanics. It is very different than it is thrust. Okay? So one need to know and develop this type of thing for the type of the speciality of Wing Chun. Okay, so that is the example of the impulse momentum. Now, if you say I do this, okay, or I do this, see this, compare with. Okay. Running, right? Running, compare with, you see again, you can analyze that with the impulse momentum theorem. That's the mechanics. So at very beginning, one need to know this, the difference. Because it's like building a building. One need to know, one need to use what type of infrastructure to build that building. Okay? And of course, again, Wing Chun is good in the short strike and the the takedown zone, but it doesn't limit to box oneself. Like I know this, long fist, right? Long fist, that doesn't limit me to not being noticed. Okay? See, that is what it is about impulse momentum. Now, so you know the Trinity, which is meaning the body, the feet, or the leg, and the arm. Okay? And you know the impulse momentum from this up to now. Now we get to the H3C. The H3C is saying that the body, the seven bowls, all the seven bowls. You can watch my other video or get the beginning Wing Chun books or the basic Wing Chun science book from me to get all these details on the seven bowls and so forth. Okay? Now, H3C is meaning that you have a training in your seven bowls. And then you know how to move your center of gravity. Like for example, okay, and or have different handling of the center of gravity with or okay. So people who walk this way or go this way have a different way of handling center gravity of this. Okay? So that's the second part, the H3C. The third thing is about this. Four handling of generations of impulse momentum. Okay? If you want to control or manage the impulse momentum in Wing Chun, there are four groups or four handles, I call it, which is on top of the seven bowls, which is need to be able to be developed and controlled. Because Wing Chun is a sticking body shastra. So all this control will be different. Okay? Namely, if I go this close, okay, either I'm going to put force into the opponent or I just stay loose. Just feel him. There are different ways of using this for handling. Okay? So you control whether you want to go tight at him or you just want to loosely sense him. Because we are here, okay? So you need to have this four handles. So now I want to go through the most fundamental basics of these four handles so you know what it is in terms of science. You see and you know, in order to fight in this zone, to play in this short strike zone and the takedown zone, you need to develop this basic. The first thing is okay, let's go through the four handles. The first handle is your feet balls and your calf area first. The second is the hip joints. The third is your lower back. The fourth is your shoulder blade with your shoulder. Okay? So let's go one by one. The first thing, the shoulder and with the shoulder blade is very important. There are actually eight ways of handling this. And today I want to show you four for the simple so that you can have a grasp. The first is when I shoot in, the way how I use my shoulder when I shoot in with the Trinity is called direct shoulder. The second type is when I press down. The way how I use my shoulder is called the press down. The third one is when I do the upper strike. That is one way of using the shoulder. The third way. The fourth way is If I let it here, I stick him here, and I separate my left and right, and I do the step, the inch power, with one side stay in the its position, and this one step, that is the four tap of using the shoulder blade and shoulder. So when one want to play in the game in here, one need to know this shoulder. When you shoot in, when you're going down, when you're going up, when you fix one side, boom, four tap shoulder. And this link to the shoulder blade handling. Okay, this is sounding short side. This thing is written there. The reason why I can detailedly describe this is because in Wing Chun there is a content of Er Mei Shi Er Zhuang, the snake slide, where every joint is handled beyond the seven bone, deeper than the seven bone. It is with that type of training in as in the Wing Chun Shi Wing Tao that one be able to refine the handlings of the shoulder. The Shaolin Short Strike have 8 types of shoulder. This is first 4 types. And the Er Mei actually provide a way to refine the handling, the snake slide. Okay? That is the shoulder. The second thing is there's 4 ways to use hip and lower back. Okay? This is in the Wing Chun, the 1850s shooting kick of Yip Gam. It's called wave. So you always say, how do you say that? When it's quiet, it is like the wave of the lake, slow wave. And when it is activate, it is like the tidal wave. So this is what it means, the lower back and the hip handling. Okay, so the first one, the first hip handling, okay, the four basic way. The first is when I want to shoot in. This is like what? This is like the American football tackle. You reap. That's how you use this and this part. Ripping in. Okay? The second, because there's a rip in and there's always a back off. Okay? This one way, this is the second way. So what is this for? Well, if he wrap me my body, okay, I can use my body. If he hug me, okay, wrap me, lock me, okay, I can use this to break a part on him, okay, to use this part. If he wrap, his hand is like this, put on my hand behind it, I can use this part to handle the momentum or impulse of mechanic on him. So you have one part here which is using for shooting. Back is for breaking up their hugging. Okay? And then you have the third. Okay? Which is when they try to throw you or anything, you just jab them. And then you have the fourth, which is when you want to shoot in to feel in his body, you shoot in and feel his body to take out his center of gravity. So there are 4 ways to doing that. In this play, okay. Now, there's one thing we need to watch out. The handler of this four handles is key important. But one need to know the seven bones. Okay? One need to develop the seven bones. And you cannot say just, I want to lose my body. You can lose for 1,000 years. If you don't know this forehand book, you still don't know it. Okay? This is not other art like Tai Chi or internal, whatever. This is Wing Chun, short strike. Okay? Now, the fourth is your calf and your feet ball, right? So calf and feet ball is the first handle, second handle, third handle, fourth handle. We cover this and two, and now we talk about this calf. Now, this calf have to watch out that at first, that feet ball, okay? Wing Chun is not rooted up because Wing Chun is a short strike. When you go in, keeping moving and striking, okay? Using the mechanic I just showed you, moving and striking. So Wing Chun do not grab the ground with the toes. Otherwise, you can try it. You grab it, you will get yourself stuck. You cannot turn anymore. Because here you need to turn a lot. Okay, turn, you're gonna change, okay? That is the feet ball. The second is, this calf need to be trained. Because say I want to shoot in high speed, okay, and or I want to go moving in the four ways of handling in this hip and the lower back. I need all the calf and stability to handle that. Either put it simple, either I want to shoot in, or I want to take the force down and play with it. I need this, the fourth handle, okay? Now, with knowing these four handles, we need to know that even when you are down on the ground, you see this 1, 2, 3 handles, your feet is up here, whether you're cuddling or move around, okay, you have to switch from this lower back handles and your shoulder handles. Okay? So the Wing Chun four handles need to be developed in order to cover the entire four momentum zone. That's Wing Chun. Okay? What is over here? I need the handle too. You see that? Even if I don't do jab that way, or I do this, okay? The knee strike, same thing, okay? So that four handles. Now, the twerking is based on those four handles. And one very critical for Wing Chun uniqueness is the inch power. Okay? Now, general people expect explode type of power generations. But Wing Chun get close doing the input type of shocking, snapping, inch power. That is the force role play. You need to be able to handle the action-reaction force play here. For example, just now we're talking about this. One shoulder is jamming, okay? And then I separate left and right. I do this, okay? That is one type of the handling. So, but I still move, right? Now, if I'm here, I don't want to move. I want to snap. That is the forceful play. That is not happen in a lot of other arts. That is Wing Chun's short jing. Okay? So one need to develop that. Okay? So, and I hope that you see this is the mechanics, impulse handling mechanics in terms of H3C, the Trinity and Force Hold. You see this thing. You see this Wing Chun mechanic. If you want to expert this in this and play with people who expert in the throwing zone and so forth, Wing Chun has to shine on this thing. This mechanics. So that's very different than this is do this. Okay. Again, this is scientific. Now, the fourth, the third in this content of Wing Chun Kim is techniques, setup, sequence, technique, setup, sequence, change within continuous impulse momentum exchange for its specialty. So it means that fighting is a continuous exchange of impulse momentum. Okay? Wing Chun is specialized in what? Second zone. And Wing Chun techniques has the setup, the sequence, and the change. So here I want to illustrate for you. So you see clearly what it is. Okay, this is no longer a usual thought of this tan da la da, those things. Okay, this is what described in the Shaolin Sword Strike. And that's document for that. Okay. So Wing Chun techniques is not just tan bong fu. Okay, those are different stuff because fighting is what? Fighting is an exchange of impulse momentum within the four momentum zone. With Wing Chun specialized in the short strike and takedown zone. So now, the first thing I want to share with you, what is this setup? Setup means at the beginning, I want to take advantage of his momentum, okay? So for example, if I face the opponent this way, I face him this way, okay, with all this power up, okay? Okay? Now, I thrust like that, He's going to come in, right? At the same time, I come in. Okay, so in zero, I'm going like this, actually I'm coming this way. Okay, so this is the dodging of shadow, right? So I strike this way, but actually I'm coming this way. So I set it up for him to move his inertia or momentum, and I slide in here with the top sound. Okay, and so this is top sound, this is how to use it. This is also is called using soft to defeat the hard. This is hard. So I'm moving in. Okay, from here, I'm moving in. Okay, this is soft. This is called setup. So instead of you letting him think that you go straight, but actually you just go in the sideways. This is setup. The second thing, sequence. Meaning that after I get into here with this top style, I strike him, right? I strike him, okay? I strike him, and right away, I execute another sequence. Once I successful left, I execute the sequence with the old shoulder strike. Now my body is keeping moving in, see? I move in, strike, okay? Move in, strike, move in, okay? And then I can do a throw. That is called sequence. Okay? Now, the third thing about change. There are two change usually. Say, I beg him, I go here. So what happened, right? Say, usually what we said, go here, we beg him, and we enter from here, right? Now, at the point when I go like that, he turn, he follow me, he's fast. So what I'm going to do? I'm going to come up here, snap him here. That is called change. The second change is, so this is a distance change while you're entering. The second change is when you are here. I slap him already, and he turned his body. He turned his body to avoid my attack toward me. And so at the same time, I wrap his hand, leg around. Okay, so his leg is here. I go like that. He turned. Okay, he turned. I hit like that. He turned. His leg is here. Right? So I wrap him around. I snap him. Okay? So he come in like that. I snap him. I come from here and snap him. So it turned like that. Okay? This is change. Here, I cannot execute anymore because he have turned. So I change. Or here, I want to come in here, but he turned. So I change. Okay? So that is what it means by setup, sequence, and change. That is the technique. That is the list, the thing, the third list. The third indie thing. Okay, in the Wing Chun contents. So techniques is just not techniques. And of course, when you do these techniques, all your the second item, the impulse, momentum handling, and biomechanics has to be able to develop that to use it. Otherwise, you cannot get in. You cannot play here. Okay, you cannot play in this game. Okay, so you need to have the second develop until you can get the third done, execute. Now the fourth is the effective mechanics and breathing synchronizations. So the idea is in Chinese martial art, in Qigong, is externally you train the bone sinews, muscle tendon. Internally you train that breathing, and you need to fuse them together. So like in other video, I show everybody when you lift up, you sit down, you inhale, always in the lower abs. That's called Xing Qi Bu Ban Tian. Okay? And in the books, Wing Chun Matrix, I'm using those two tools, the hiking poles, to put in here to help develop the Xing Qi of Ban Tian. So the idea is this. The idea is usually before using this forward, this front part, get the knee and so forth to jam out, and that's why you cannot breathe properly. And you use this as a transitional tool so that you train the back muscle and you no longer use this part, which is jamming up. And when you need to use soup, your calf and everything, you need this type of mechanic being to use the back of your leg. So this is giving details instruction in the book to develop that. And once you develop that, your breathing automatically naturally sink. Down to the low abs. Only after get this, you can talk about Qi channel. Without this, forget about it. And usually people don't require to go for the Qi channels. If one can have this four develops, the specialized in the short strike and takedown momentum zone, impulse momentum handling biomechanics, technique setup sequence change, and the fusions of the physical biomechanics and the breathing, it is already at the advanced level. So it's very rare people have the channel training. Okay, even though it is written in the Xiu Lin Tao Quick of Yi Gang, 1850. Okay. So this is what Wing Chun, according to the ancient, and we now express or map into the modern science and illustrate what it is. Okay? Now, so That is what I want to share with you. I make this list so that I do not forget things, okay? So I hope that with this and with the three books, the Wing Chun Mechanics, the beginning Wing Chun, the basic ancient Wing Chun Art and Science, which is the 6th of Wing 3, and the Wing Chun Magic 3 books give you a scientific base on what is Wing Chun. Okay? And it's like a scientific a school textbook. Okay. So here I like to it's my time. I'm going to leave everything to you. And of course I never be perfect. I'm just doing my job to do as much as possible. Okay? And you guys continues on in the science. So this is for you. I bow out and good luck.